Hey guys, welcome back to electronicsinnovation.com. In this video, we are going to see how to interface this Sds011 sensor with ESP8266 or modem CU module. By the way, I would like to thank Altium designer for sponsoring this video, but more on this later in the episode. For now, let's dive into the episode. For this project, you will need an ESP8266 module, jumper wires, breadboard, and Sds011 PM sensor. This Sds011 stands out as a renowned air quality sensor designed to measure particulate matter in the air. Its functionality is rooted in the principle of laser scattering. The air will enter from this nozzle, and here in this location there will be a laser diode and also a photodiode here. When particles in the air scatter the laser light, this deflection is detected by photodetector. This is an amplifier circuit. Notably, the sensor adapts at detecting particles of sizes 2.5 micrometer and 10 micrometers, often referred as PM2.5 and PM10. That's why we call this sensor as PM sensor. It's worth noting that these readings are pivotal indicators of environmental pollution. Elevated PM values pose significant health risks, especially concerning the respiratory system. Kindly refer to the on-screen image for the sensor specification. Feel free to pause the video if you wish to delve deeper. Moving on, let's examine the circuit diagram. This illustration showcases the connectivity between Sds011 and the ESP8266 module. I have taken the liberty of presetting the circuit as per the diagram. If you are making it now, make sure you connect the wires to the right pins of the ESP8266 as well as Sds011 sensor. If it's all good, let's see how to program it. In our programming journey, first we will add software serial diagramming. This lets us talk to the other devices using the ESP8266 pins. Delving into the code, our initial step is to define the pins for Sds011 sensors RX and TX lines. As we already knew that we have connected the D5 and D6 pins of the ESP8266 to the Sds011 sensor, we have to mention the same here. Following this, we will initial the software serial instance aptly named as SDS to foster the communication with our sensor. Within the setup function, we will start the serial communication with the computer using the baud rate of 115200 following a brief initialization message. Also, we will set the stage for our software serial communication with Sds011 sensor operating at baud rate of 96000. The loop function pivots around the scouting for a data frames from the Sds011 sensor. A frame's inception is signified by the byte of 0xAA. Upon locating this byte, our next mission is to read the subsequent 9 bytes of the frame. The authenticity of the frame is validated by its concluding byte 0xAB. Having a genuine data frame, we proceed to distill the PM2.5 and PM10 values from the byte data. Subsequently, these values undergo a transformation into integers, representing the particulate matter concentration in micrograms per cubic meter. Our final task in this process involves relaying these values to our serial monitor, refined to 2 decimal places for accuracy. After showing the numbers, we will wait for 1 second before looking for next message. That's a simple explanation of the code. Now let's configure the Arduino IDE to program the ESP8266. Navigate to Tools, Board, and pick the appropriate ESP8266 port. In my case, it's NodeMCU 1.0 ESP12E module. Now connect your ESP8266 to your computer using the micro B cable. In the software, go to Tools, Port, and pick the port where the ESP8266 is connected. With all elements aligned and everything is ready now, click on Upload to send the code to ESP8266. Wait till you see Done Uploading message. Till the code uploads to ESP8266, let's talk about Altium Designer. Altium design is the standard for PCB design. This is because it's an all-in-one feature-rich design environment with a modern, powerful and unique approach to design. Whether you're designing small or large, simple or complex, Altium Designer has you covered. With the support for high-speed, HDI and rigid flex, there is nothing it can't handle. One of the main technologies behind all these capabilities is the industry-leading interactive routing engine, which is capable to push and shove the object's length tune with a built-in electromagnetic field solver and route at any angle. That's why I have been using this Altium Designer for my personal projects as well as professional projects. Get a free trial of Altium Designer, the world's most trusted PCB design software, and also get 25% off on your purchase using the link from the description of the video. Yes, now we got the done uploading. Post upload, open the serial monitor by selecting the magnifying glass icon position top right of the Arduino IDE. Now you can see the real-time PM2.5 and PM10 readings on the serial monitor. At start, you will see the data which is not stable. We have to leave the setup for at least 10 to 15 minutes to settle the environment. After 15 minutes of waiting time, now I can see the stable values. Right now, the PM2.5 and PM10 values in my lab are as follows. And I think I am currently living in a good environment. So that's all for today. Now you have a fully operational air quality monitor using Sds011 and ESP8266. See you soon on the next interesting project. Bye bye.